Welcome to a video on the comparison test for the convergence of an infinite series. If we have two infinite series, a sub n and b sub n, such that they're both greater than zero, and a sub n is less than or equal to b sub n, then if the infinite series b sub n converges, then so does the infinite series a sub n. And if the infinite series a sub n diverges, then so does the infinite series of b sub n. To make sense of this, let's consider the case where a sub n is smaller than b sub n. This is just telling us that if the larger series converges, then so does the smaller series. And if the smaller series diverges, then so does the larger series. If we think of it in this way, I think it's easier to remember. Let's take a look at some examples. We want to determine if this infinite series converges or diverges using the comparison test. To apply the comparison test, we have to be able to recognize another infinite series that we already know about that converges or diverges. Now this looks very similar to the formula 1 over n squared, which we could apply the p-series test to. So let's try comparing this to the infinite series of 1 over n squared. Well, this series converges since p is equal to 2 by the p-series test. With p equals 2, which is greater than 1. So since we know this series converges, if we can show that this series here is less than this series, we can conclude by the comparison test that this series converges as well. So let's see if that's true. Is 1 over n squared plus 3 less than 1 over n squared? Well, let's go and just check it with a few values of n. If we have n equals 1, we'd have 1/4, and over here we'd have 1. Well, that's true. Let's go ahead and try n equals 2. Well, here we'd have 2 squared plus 3, that'd be 1/7 less than 1/4. And now we can probably conclude that this denominator is always going to be larger than this denominator. Therefore, 1 over n squared plus 3 will always be less than 1 over n squared, which is enough to conclude by the comparison test, this series does converge. So again, it took two steps. Number one, we had to determine a series that we knew converged or diverged. Since we knew this series converged, we wanted to show that the given series was less than the converging series. We did that, and therefore we can conclude that the given series does converge. Let's go and take a look at another one. Here we have the summation of 1 over the square root of n minus 2. Looking at this, it should remind us of the summation of 1 over the square root of n. So let's go ahead and try comparing it to that series. Well, we can rewrite this as 1 over n to the 1/2 power. And based upon the form of this infinite series, we can apply the p-series test where p equals 1/2. Therefore, we know that this series diverges. So by the p-series test with p equal to 1/2, which is less than or equal to 1, this series diverges. Now, since the series we're comparing it to diverges, if we can now show the given series would be larger than this divergent series, we can conclude by the comparison test that this series also diverges. So let's go ahead and see if that's true. Is 1 over the square root of n minus 2 greater than 1 over the square root of n? Well, we can probably tell already that this fraction here is going to have smaller denominators than this fraction here because We're subtracting 2 from n before we find the square root. But just to verify, let's go ahead and pick some values of n. And notice that n starts at 3. So if n is equal to 3, we'd have 1 over the square root of 1, or 1, greater than, this would be 1 over the square root of 3. That's true. Let's go and just try one more value of n. If n is 4, we'd have 1 over the square root of 2, greater than 1 over square root of 4, that'd be 1/2. Well, this fraction here has a larger denominator, and therefore it would be smaller. So that does verify that this inequality is true. So that's enough information to verify that by the comparison test, the given series diverges. Let's take a look at this last problem. We have the infinite series generated by 1 over n factorial. So the challenging part on this one is to determine a series that we can compare it to. Remember, n factorial would be n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 all the way down to times 3 times 2 times 1. So let's start by trying to compare n factorial to 2 to the power of n. And in most cases, n factorial would be greater than or equal to 2 to the nth. The only time it wouldn't be is if n was equal to 1, because then we'd have 1 over here and this would be 2. So there's a couple ways we could do this. We could let n only be greater than or equal to 2, or we could just subtract 1 from this exponent. Now when n is equal to 1, this would be 1 and this would be 2 to the 0, which is also 1. So now this statement is true for n greater than or equal to 1. So these numbers are always larger than these numbers. So if we took the reciprocal of these two, then we'd have to reverse the inequality. What I mean by that is, if we know that 3 is greater than or equal to 2, if we take the reciprocals of those, 1/3 and 1/2, we can't use the same inequality symbol because now 1/2 is larger. So we'd have to reverse the inequality. So using this notation here, we could state that 1 over n factorial is less than or equal to 1 over 2 to the n minus 1 factorial. So we're going to use the series generated by this formula for the comparison test. Now we have to be able to look at this series and recognize that it's geometric. Notice that as n increases, we multiply the denominator by additional factors of 2. When multiplying the denominator by 2 each time, it's the same as multiplying by 1/2. So if I wanted to, I could rewrite this as the summation of n equals 1 to infinity of 1 times 1 over 2 raised to the n minus 1 power. Notice raising 1 to the power of n minus 1 is always still going to be 1. The reason I wanted to do this is to make it more obvious that this is a geometric series where r is equal to 1/2. So by the geometric series test, with r equal to 1/2, which is less than 1, this series converges. So if we're comparing it to this series and it converges, we want to show that 1 over n factorial is less than or equal to 1 over 2 to the n minus 1. We already developed this idea when coming up with the series to compare it to, but let's go ahead and test this with a couple of values of n. If n is equal to 1, we'd have 1 over 1 factorial, that would be 1, less than or equal to, this would be 1 over 2 to the 0 power, which is 1 as well, so that's true. Let's go ahead and try n equals 2. Now we'd have 1 over 2 factorial, that would be 1/2. And here we'd have 1/2 as well. Let's go ahead and try n equals 3 and then we'll stop. When n equals 3, we'll have 1 over 3 factorial, that's 1/6. And over here we'll have 2 to the 3 minus 1 power, it's 2 squared, or 1/4. So now it becomes very clear that 1 over n factorial is always going to be less than or equal to 1 over 2 to the n minus 1. And since this series converges, so does the given series by the comparison test. One of the challenges about the comparison test is to come up with the correct infinite series to compare it to. But it does allow you to apply what you already know about converging and diverging infinite series to different types of infinite series. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.